Hey, what's up Blender users, I'm Jonathan, and in today's video we will take a look at the pixel sorting effect, which allows us to create renders like this one. We will very quickly create an abstract render in Blender, and then port it over to GIMP to create this pixel sorting effect. This whole process is really easy, and I wanted to share it with you. Oh, and by the way, if you enjoy my content, consider subscribing, because I upload a new video every Saturday. And yes, because so many people have asked me to do it, I'm currently working on a visual effects tutorial, which will hopefully come out next week. And with that said, let's get started. So, I'm currently in Blender 2.9, which you can download off the Blender website. And let's just add an A cube. We will go into edit mode, W, and subdivide it once. Great, now we can select the extrude region tool right here. And if we hold left click, we can actually select extrude, dissolve and intersect. This is a new tool in Blender 2.9, which is basically the implementation of the destructive extrude add-on. So now we can extrude this mesh destructively, just like this. And let's also do this until we get a mesh that looks a bit like this one right here. And now we basically just want to destroy this object with modifiers. Firstly, let's add an A bevel modifier and disable clamp overlap. This already gives it a pretty broken look. Now we can crank up the offset just like this and also turn up the segments until we get a mesh that looks like this. Now let's add an A solidify modifier. This will give us some more geometry to work with and also turn up the thickness. Okay, after the solidify modifier, let's add an A mirror modifier and mirror our mesh on the X and Y axis. This will give us some consistency in the really broken mesh in the end. And lastly, let's add the wireframe modifier, and this really breaks our mesh. If you choose other parameters, in for example the bevel modifier, you will now get really different results, as you can see right here. And I really like this one, so let's go with this. For the render, I will just set up a camera right here and add in a simple background, just a plane, which we can move back. The lighting isn't really different from this tutorial, which will be linked on the screen right now, so you can check this out if you want to see how I lighted the scene. Now we just have to enable denoising data and denoise our render. I also added in a simple glare node, which helps our render a lot. You can see that this was the mesh I went for in the end, and I placed a little lamp right here just to give it a highlight. And in the viewport it looks like this. I mean, this is pretty cool, but how can we turn this render right here into an image that looks like this? Well, for this we will have to use GIMP and an add-on which is called Gimmick. The website is gimmick.eu, and if you go on it, this is how it looks. You will just have to go to download and download the latest installer for your operating system. Once you've done this, let's open GIMP. Okay, let's load on our render, and this is how it looks right now. Okay, now let's go to filters and start Gimmick. A new window will pop up and we can just search for pixel, and you can already see pixel sort right here. Okay, if we click on it, we can see that this happens, which is really not what we want. Every single pixel in our image is right now being sorted, but we only want certain parts of the image to be affected. So we can preview our mask, and this determines which pixels are being sorted. And if we turn down the slider, we can see that now these black pixels are not being sorted. Okay, but I actually want it the other way around, so let's check invert mask. And if we turn this further down, we can see that we get a pretty good area for this filter. So let's uncheck preview mask, and we can see that we get this effect, which is looking pretty cool. We can also, for example, change to the y-axis, so now it is being sorted downwards, but I will stay on the x-axis. We can also choose between increasing and decreasing, which will just change the directions. And of course, because this is a black and white image, we can choose luminance as our sorting criteria. Okay, let's press OK. And there you have it. This is how you can use the pixel sorting effect on your renders. This hopefully gives you some new cool ideas on what to create, and we will see us next Saturday in the next video.